and how many different type of groups, how to verify the groups also. Okay, so this is a module 2, just I shared it, so go through once. Okay, what is a user account, how to add a user account, different ways to add a user accounts also it will show. Okay, one is user Active Directory users and computers. You can go administrative center, PowerShell, and CMD prompt also you can add a user. And different type of things are there, like account and all. Create a user, delete a user, move a user, configure attributes. You can do it yourself, like profile paths. Already I told this one. Okay, inactive, disable accounts also you can do it. Okay, these are the group types. What are the group types? Distribution group and security group. So these are a group types. Two type of groups are there, that is distribution group and security group first. Okay, now group types. When it is come to the group types, it is two type of groups. One is security group and a distribution group. Okay, so what is this security group? Security group has a SID. Every account, guys, when it comes to the account, means user, group, computer, any printer, scanner, storage, everything is a comes under, once it is comes under and as an account in a domain, so every account has a SID. Every account has a SID. What is a SID? Security identifier. Security identifier. Okay, otherwise you can search in Google for exact what is SID. Active Directory. So what is it? Is it's a secure identifier, a security identifier, security identifier. Okay, same thing, only they given a capitals for this one. Security identifier. The structure of this security, who is having this SID? SID, so first we'll go to the what is this SID, because I didn't go to one big PPT is there, so I didn't go to that one, so to cover up all here. So who is having SID? Users, because user is an account, right? User, group, OU, organizational unit, computer, okay, user, administrators, groups, group or a groups, OUs, computers, resources, services, okay, resources, services, okay, all these things have a SID. All these things have a SID. So I am not typing everything, okay. So you understand. So user, group, OUs, computers. So what are the thing as it is, like it is a having an SID. So this SID is a combination of few things. So what is this SID in a combinedly? First it is type of account it is. What is the type of account it is, first one. And next one is ADDS. Active Directory database location. Next one is RID. Okay. Unique ID number that computer and domain controller uses to identify. It is a string of alphanumeric assigned to each user on a Windows computer, or to each user, group, computers on a domain controller network, such as a Indiana Universities Act to directory something is try to give explanation it is. Okay, like this. I need a SID to look at this one is a SID. So this is a SID. So Microsoft actually SID is three parts. One is like yes, represent it is an SID. Okay, merely identify a following string as being an SID. Okay, next it is like a revision level identifier authority sub. Authority sub authority to etc something it is it change the pattern, but you can see to date this is a never change, always been one. So yes hyphen one is always constant. Okay, they are given a much depth of this one, we don't need. Guys, this last one is called RID. This last one you can see it is RID. This is a type of ID. This is a type of ID. Okay, so what it is, user group like that. Okay, user group like that. Okay, I didn't given much information based. Okay, so this is like a type of ID. If you create a user, if you create a group, if you create something, so it is a it's showing like this. And next this is your Active Directory part. Okay, identify authority, identify sub authority, sub authority number two is showing right here. Okay, like this. So this is maybe identify authority. This is what we can say this parts Active Directory locations. So what is your Active Directory database number is there, no? So that a unique number is like this. But here it is giving what is SID. It is given some good I know it is moving here. Okay. Just it's a name is given like this, but just for understanding purpose only. Okay, so any account has an SID in the system, like usually users, group, computers, OUs having a SID. So SID is like a type of ID, and Active Directory database, and final part is RID. Okay, next, what is this RID? RID is a relative identifier. RID is a relative identifier. What is RID? RID is a relative identifier. So you can see from here, for example, I created an account. For example, I created a user account. Okay, for example, I created a user one. So something SID will be there, right? So SID 1, 5, something, whatever it is. Okay, yes. So capless hyphen 1 hyphen 5 hyphen something 32 hyphen some numbers. And now, for example, just 1001. This is my user 1. Then I created a user 2. This only will change. Rest is constant. Rest is constant. For example, I created a user 3. Okay, I created a user 3. The rest one is constant. RID only will change. So what is this meaning of this one is, so SID having a RID like a user identifier or a group identifier, it is a differentiate between one user to another user or one group to another group. So this RID will be always adding 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. Okay, like in a Linux also you seen user ID, group ID, same thing. Everybody has a identification, right? But in a Windows operating system, it contains a SIDs. It's a security identifier. Okay, and security identifier is a combination of few things, like it is a SID and a constant one, like a 1, and it is showing a, like a, this is type of ID type. It is a Active Directory database, the location or Active Directory database number it is, and this is important, it is RID. So what is the relative identifier will show like this. Okay, if you want to see SID RID of this be our users also, we can able to see, but we need a PowerShell command. Okay, and we need a little bit patience for that one. Why it is taking a lot of time? Because I opened this thing almost first time. Unnecessarily I went to this part or what? So PowerShellCommand.com, PowerShell, Windows PowerShell. That is these two things we do. Okay, so if you are want to practice PowerShell commands and scripting of PowerShell commands, little bit doubt, so then we need a more guideline kind of stuff. There is a PowerShell ISE is there, so you can try with the PowerShell ISE also. I'm changing my font size. Okay, so even size changes, still it is very small one. Okay, it's okay, no problem. So we'll try get, because of first time commands, the first commands will take time. Okay, okay, get hyphen ad user. Okay, it's a get only, right? So for creating new ad user to get information, so get hyphen ad user Active Directory user something is very slow. You know, so when we want to show something new, then obviously it will give you that one, and it makes forget what you are doing also. It contains hyphen identity. Okay, good. Based my search way of searching also. Now it is working. Okay, get ad user hyphen identity is id user 1. Yeah, like this. Okay, so I try to find a username like this. This is the location of user, and you can see it's a SID of this one. Can you see this SID? S1521. This is a database number, and 115. For example, I want to see for 2. Like, can you see this one? Both are same information up to here, same information, but this is 1105 and this is 1107. I created another account. So if you see, it is 116. So 1106. But if you see, this is the number is not almost same. It is same only. Administrator SID is 500. Administrator SID is 500. You can see, sir, user principal name. User principal name. This is SAM account name. Okay, like that. Administrators. So because it's a get AD user, right? AD group. So administrator, this is SID. So the administrators group SID is this one. So what I will do to show you other differences, okay, I'm going to this Accurate users and computers. Okay, so I want to create a two groups. What is that group? The group name is one of the group new. So this is IT support. I click on this empty space. I click on IT support. I click on empty space, new group. I will show you again. Right click, new group. Okay, new group. So here it is showing where it is. See, group types, security group and distribution group. Sorry guys, security group and distribution. We'll go to the groups later, but what is the difference between security group and distribution group, we'll see. So I'll put a V. So I will put everything in caps. Okay, V security, V just I put a V. V S means security, G means group 1. So I creating a security group. Okay, now okay, so I created a security group. Next, I'm creating another group. So IT support, click on IT support, and in this empty space I'm clicking new group. Next, I'm selecting group type V. Distribution group I'm creating VDG1. Okay, VDG1. Okay, so VDG1 is a distribution group, and VSG1 is a security group. Currently it is a global group, no balance, so we'll see that one later. So here we have to verify the SIDs. Okay, so anyway, it is AD group is showing. First is VS D VSG1, right? So this is a group. Okay, that is administrator, that way it may be showing like that. Okay, but can you see, this is a SID 21, like this, right? Okay, it is also showing for a user, also showing 21. Okay, so okay, no problem. This is a type of ID, and this is also common, 1109. RID is a 1109. Next, where happened? Here it is. Here it is VDG1, distribution group. distribution group also having SID, but it should not have SID. But as per the server, any group, any account should have a SID. See, this is a SID of this one. This is a SID of this one. Okay, so sad. Like we got a SID for distribution group also. Okay, so but that is how to verify SID. But both are having SID as per the our PPT. Like see, distribution group. Okay, not a security enabled. No SID. Cannot give permissions. Distribution give not used for permission. Only for group mailing purpose only. Only for group mailing purpose only. Security group. Security group is a security principal with SID. Can give and permissions. Can also be email enabled. So this is the difference between security group and distribution group. And we verified. So we both are having a SID, but we will verify with other ways. So what I want to do is, so I'm going to security group. So I'm going to security group. Members. So who is a member of that group? I'm adding a members. Add IT user one. Check names. So I type IT user one, check names, click OK. It means in this group, group member is IT user one. Apply, okay, that's it. Now I'm going to IT user one, open it, member of, can you see VSG1? So add a user to this group from here only, from group. I went to group, I went to members and add a user to it. So in this group, I have a user, IT user one. If you verify from IT user one, member of VSG1. So IT user one is a member of VSG1. Next, this is a IT user two. So I open IT user two. I open IT user two, member of, nothing is showing here, right? Add V, check names, VSG1. Okay, see, I added a user to group. So like this also, we can add a users to group. Like you can see members. Now can you see two users are there? So we can directly, we can open a group, we can add a users to the group, or you can open the user and you can add a user to the group. And sometimes a group can be a member of other groups also, guys. A group can be a member of other groups also. And already you know what is the use of this group. Okay, so we'll see that one. This is VDG1, members, add, for example, IT user one. Okay, now if you see IT user one is a member of VSG1 and VDG1. You know why I put a V? For easy to search. So if you see, it is add. If I press V, check names, automatically the list is coming. So make it more easy to access, I put a VV. AA, BB, CC, you can put it. But certain letters like a kind of stuff, A is usually like assigned to so many things, like administrators group or backup administrators, B, okay, like domain admins, domain users, domain computers, D is occupied. So like that. So better to use a more unique letter to access the things like this. Okay. So this is how we can able to add it to a group. So you can add it like this also. Right click on a user, add to a group. So then you can type a group name and you can also add it. Next. This is a file, or okay, this is a file. Some file is there. Is it an open file or a closed file? Open file. So save it and close it. For a file or a directory, just for example, right click, properties, security, edit, add. I'm giving a permission to my both. We'll check it. See, I got a VDZ one directly. It should show, it must show both the names, right? But it is going to VS G1 only. So it is showing a VS G1 only, but it is not showing a VDZ1. Otherwise, I will type it VDZ1. Check names. It is throwing some error. Name not found. Why name not found? Why name not found? VDZ1 is existing, but I can't give you security permission. That is the meaning of the text. It means for a, on a file or a directory or a printer or anything, for distribution groups won't get permissions. So you can't assign a permission to distribution groups. That is the meaning of this one. For distribution groups, it cannot give permissions to the distribution groups. In security groups, you can give the permission to security group. Group wise, you can able to give permission. That is the two things. Next. There is a group scopes. So local group means, so any server has its own local group, mean in respect of PC type. Okay. Group types I'm here. Okay, so like it is, you can go. So then next one is group scope. What is this group scope? There is a different groups are there. Normally every PC has its own group called as a local group. That is local group. But domain wise different groups are there, like a domain local group. Next, so global group, universal group. I think I will take it in within a 20-30 minutes only, but it is taking time. No problem. So just give me a 5-10 minutes and then I will complete this one. Okay, domain local group, global group, and universal group. These are mainly three type of groups. When you're creating a group, okay, so automatically it's giving an options, right? So new group, say group scope, domain local group, global group, and universal group. For example, if I want to create a domain local group, so I will create it like I will use V only, V D L G1. Okay, so I created a domain local group. Then I'm creating another one is global group. So VGG1 global group. Why I put a one? Because I want to create actually two. Okay, VUG1 universal group. So I'm open VDG1 again. So can you see it's a domain local group, but I can't convert into global group, but I can convert into universal group. So that is also there here. Okay, if you see VGG1, it's a global group, I can't convert into domain local group. VUG1 is a universal group. Universal can be convert into anyone. So that is the first one. Second one is, this is a domain local group. We'll see members and member of. Okay, members and member of part. Okay, we'll show you. I will show you that one. Okay, later. First, understand what is these groups. Okay, so this is my domain. Domain represent in a triangle manner. So this is my domain. Okay, next. This is my forest. Forest represent big zero. Okay, this is my forest. This is my domain. Okay, and this is another domain. two domains. Just for example, okay, here it is. This is my domain one, and this is my domain two. This is my forest. Anyway, so forest name is like Vedic forest. Vedic.com. So of course that domain is also should be there. Okay, so we'll see that one later. But okay, here it is, domain one, domain two. For example, there is a user here, name is user one in the domain one. So want to access resources in the domain. So what is the resources? Like computers, printers, storage, okay, anything. So in this one, you want to access it. So like maybe you want to access a printer or a scanner or a storage or a computer, you want to access. So he's a member of this domain, he can able to access it. He's a member of this domain. This user is a member of this domain. He can, by default, he can able to access the local resources. So member of the domain local group can access the local resources, first statement. Second statement is member of the domain can able to access the domain local resources. Member of the domain can able to access local resources. Domain local resources. Second, member of the domain local group can access domain local resources. Got the point? Member of domain can access domain local resources. Okay, next, member of domain local group can access domain local resources. Means that domain only. For example, I have a domain A, for example, domain one is there. Okay, in this user one is there. It meaning is user one can access domain one resources. Okay, next, in domain one in domain two, I create a group. So for example, DLG 21 group. So this is a domain local group. I created a domain local group. This is domain local group I created. Okay, so I created a domain local group. So member of DLG21 can access domain two resources. Okay, understand the statement. Okay. So we'll see the example, because we splitted a names for that one. So we'll see. For example, user one want to access domain to local resources. User one want to access domain to local resources. He is a member of domain one, not a member of domain two. Within the forest, domains will trust each other. So this user one want to access this domain two. Then how to access? He is not a member of this domain. He has no rights to access resources. Then how he can able to access? So I created a group called DLG 2 1 group. So I created a group like this. Now what I done? This is a local group of domain 2. This is a local domain local group of domain 2. So this I given a permission to access resources. So for a certain resources, I given a permission, access permission to this group. I given a access permission to this group and a certain access permissions only, right? Next, I add this user to this group. Who is this group? This belongs to domain 2 only. This is belongs to domain 2 only. So member of this group. So U1 is a member of this one, and U1 automatically can able to access resources. Now domain local one group can give permission to access, of course, to which one you are giving, that one you can, like a storage, printer, scanner, like that, okay, computer, like that. So you created a group, that is domain local group. Member of the domain local group can able to access this one. Okay, so where, which one is we given? Okay, next. So how to add this user? So this user one cannot add directly to global domain local group. So what we have to do is we have to create a group in our here. So we have to create a group here, a global group. We have to create a group called global group one. For example, I created a group name is global group one. In the domain one, I create a global group. I created a global group one. Now what I done, I make the member, user one is a member of global group one. Global group one is a member of domain local group three one. See, if you see here, it is user one is a member of global group one. Okay, user one, which user it is? Domain one user. Global group one, okay, GG one is belongs to domain one only, domain one only. But I make this group, global group, a member of DLG 1121. It means it is belongs to domain 2. So because of this membership, so for example, this is given a permission to access a particular folder, for example, a storage. So where I given permission to this global, this group. So this user can able to access the resources. But how to access? User one is a member of global group. That global group is a member of domain local group. Domain local group is assigned to certain, assigned to access a resource. So that resource can able to access it by user one. So that is the hierarchical part. Okay, of course universal group also there. For example, universal group UG1 here. If I add this user to UG1, then user can able to access outside of my forest also. Okay, so outside of forest, for example, like this, I have a domain. Okay, so like you want to access this one, first I'll put this user added to universal group. So make him as a universally go outside of my domain, universal group, like that. Understand this part? Okay, whether you understand or not, so we'll see you again in the here. Domain local groups, just read it if you can, it can possible. Universal group, global groups. Also there is a table, is this is a very important, guys. So when you read it, this is all are same line only. It is not a abbreviation. It is a single line only. I G D L A. This is entirely a single line only. What is this line? So I means identity, G means global group, DL means global group, sorry, domain local group, A means assigned to access, assigned to access. But we have to read it everything in a single voice only. How to read it? Identities, users or a computers, which is the member of global group, which collects member based on a member's roles, which are a member of domain local group, which provide management such as a resources access, which are assigned access to resources. So everything is a single line only. If you see sales auditors, global group, global group. I create domain local group. So sales global group, auditors global group is a member of domain local group now. So if I assign this domain local group to access a folder access or a printer access or maybe a particular storage access or network related access or a system access, so the users of this sales group, users in the auditors group get a access permission to that resources. So this is a group management. Okay. There is a default groups are there. There are a lot of things are there, but these are the default groups. Enterprise admin. If you are a member of enterprise admins group, so you are the administrator of the entire forest. If you are a member of schema admins, then you can change the way of the schema, means the blueprint, you can able to change it. A lot of things are there to discuss. If I add you to the administrators group, then you can manage the server. If I add a user to domain admins and he is the administrator of all the domain computer users groups and everything, we can valid. So any user become a domain admin. For example, I have an account, right? So I will show you that account. So I'm taking a lot of time. Okay, so here you can see users, administrators, domain admins. For example, I have an account here, Sirisha, like right click, add to a group. Can you able to view this one? See guys, it is domain admins group is there. By default, members are administrators only. But I want to make a normal user as a domain admin. So how to do it? Right click on the user, add to a group, and type domain, check names. So domain admins. Okay. So this user is normally a domain user. Now I make the user as a domain admins. Add to group successfully completed. Now this user is automatically a domain admin because of the membership. Okay. Like you can add, like you can add a user to enterprise admin, or you can add a user to schema admin. You can add a user for a Hyper-V. Okay, RODC. So we can make a user as a administrator by adding a user to that particular group. Okay. So each thing is like that. Server operator, account operator, backup operator, print operator, set publishers, like this. These groups are a default groups, and a member of that group automatically gain the control of certain resources. This is a special identities are there. Anonymous login means without username and password, we can access certain things, right? So like it is called a anonymous login, like a website. You are open, without giving your username and password, just a request and send and you are logging, right? That is like a anonymous login. Everyone, anyone, so that is user is not required to be there in a domain user or authentication, no verification for accessing a particular folder or a particular services. So everyone means anybody, so irrespective of the type of user it is also, okay, anyone, anonymous, not required a username also here. Interactive, asking questions, interactive means like username, password, like that. Network, anybody access through network, that is a network user. Create a owner, who created a file, directory, or a disk, or like who created it. So based on that, create a owner. Like last time, we changed the ownership for IT user to profile data in server. So like that. Okay, create a owner, who created it. Okay, like that. And important is authenticated users. Okay, important is two things. One is everyone, another one is authenticated user, create owner, three things. What is authenticated user? Every user is authenticated user. It means they got authenticated only. For example, here I have a three users totally in my server. IT user 1, IT user 2, and in a HR I put a Sirish also, right? So here okay, so for example, I log in with IT user 1. Okay, already I log in, right? So in a client, already log in. It means he done authentication. So that is called authenticated users. IT user 2, a login, a logout, login, logout, right? So once I log in, so authentication will be done, right? So authentication, it's verify username and password. It means authenticated user. I am not at login with this account. I'm not at login with this account. I login with the two accounts only, but I didn't login with this account. So what is the what is this user? Is not authenticated user. It's not authenticated. I'm not saying non-authenticated. It's saying I'm saying not at authenticated. So it's not a authenticated user because I didn't log in with this user either in same PC or a client PC or through log anything. So I done not done authentic. So this user is not authenticated user. These two users are authenticated users. What is the difference? I log in with IT user 1, IT user 2 already once, at least once in a client PC, right? This user I not at login. So automatically non-authenticated users. But if you log in, authenticated user only it will become. So these are the different things. Okay, so if you see, look at the PPTs, look like lot of PPTs are there, but see, once you go very small PPTs only. Okay, you can understand what is required and not required. You can see how to create a user, how to get the information of a particular user groups, OUs, computers. Okay, we can find about those information. This is very useful PowerShell commands, guys. If possible, copy all these PowerShell commands into one particular location, okay, or a notes, because it's worked like a cheat sheets also. It's work like a sheet is also sometimes. Okay, so this is about your groups. Actually, I will tell which group can add it to which group. Okay, we'll see. This is DLG, domain local group, members add. I want to add any group here. So you can in DLG universal group and global group, we can able to add it. Okay, we'll see that one. Member of DLG can be added. Only DLG one only. It's not showing that big list also. Only we DLG one only. It means understand. Yeah, this is a very good diagram. Okay, vegetable vendor. See. here it is. DLG means domain local group can join to only domain local group only, but global group, universal group can join to DLG. Okay, so anybody like DL, domain local group, any name it is domain local group, can be a member, means can be a member of domain local group, can be a member of domain local group, but domain local group can be a member of domain local group only. So forget about 1-1, but generally I'm telling can be a member of domain local group. He cannot be a member of, we cannot be a member, so we can't add a domain local group to universal group, so we can't add it. So this is the primary thumb rule, primary rule. Next, global group. You can go to global group. This is the global group. Members, V. It is showing a list. VDG1, distribution group. This is also global group. Forget about this one. Global group, global group. So, VG1, members. Members means who can able to add a global group, only global group, members of, member of, entire list is a DLG1. What is that? DLG1 means local group, domain local group, global group. Okay, and what is this? Global group, universal group. Okay, like this. What I'm doing, see, it is global group. Global group is like you can members. Members means we can add a global group to global group only. But like a global group members are global group members only. So it can, so DLG, you can't add it to global group. So like this, DLG or universal groups, we can't add these groups to global group. We can't do it. Next, global group. Global group, we can add it to everyone. So we can add a global group, means global group can be a member of domain local group, global group, and universal group also. So this is the thing. One more last universal group. This is universal group, members. 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 Add V. Check names. Universal group, global group. Universal group, global group. Domain local group is not there. Members. Universal group, global group. Member of domain local group and universal groups only. Member of. We don't have a space to do it, that one. So no problem. So I will use this place. Actually, use this place also. No problem. I will universal group members. Members, universal group and a global group, because domain local group can be a member of anything. So global group, we can add a global group to universal group and
universal group to universal group, and he can be a member of, he can be a member of everyone, DLG. Okay. And global group and universal group. No, not global group. Universal group can be a member of domain local group or other universal group. Like, okay, not a global group. So this is the situation. It cannot. It cannot be a member of global group. It cannot be a member of global group. Okay. It means like UG can directly DLG, but UG GG DLG is not there. So this is, we can't add like this. Okay. So try to understand. It is okay if you are get confused or anything. It is okay, no problem. But understand the groups. Okay, how to add? First thing we have to understand, important thing is, what is a group? What is the use of group? Like a user is a member of group. Okay, what is a group? And next one is how to add user to group. So how many ways you can able to add it? One way, two way, third way, like that. From user, from group, from directly we can adding like this. How to add a user to group? Okay. Next is what is distribution group and security group? How to create? How to verify? Next, what is a domain local group? What is a domain local group? What is the importance of domain local group? What is the importance of domain local group? And other groups like a global group and universal group and local group. So these things are important. Okay. So this is about your groups.